In just a moment, I'm going to take you through a tutorial that will help you use your home computer to do a search for a cell phone number. This is a way of using the internet to do a free cell phone lookup to find out who's been calling your cell. Now, it's not a completely foolproof method, and it's not guaranteed to work every time, but it's certainly worth a try. If you don't come up with any luck using this method and you really do need to find out somebody's cell phone number, exactly who they are, then probably the best place to go is the reversephonedirectory.net. It is a service where they'll charge you a small fee, but it is certainly worth it if you really need to find out quite urgently who's been calling your cell phone. Okay, but for now, let's give the free method a try. We're going to head across to Google, and we're going to punch in a number. We're kind of selecting something, you know, a little bit random here. And apologies up front if this happens to be your number. We're using this just as an exercise. Google stores all sorts of information that people enter onto web pages, whether that's in their MySpace account or somebody might be entering their personal details in a job board, or you know, maybe they've just decided to sell their sofa and they didn't want to hang around to answer the landline at home, and they've dropped this cell number in there. There's just an endless number of ways that people use the internet to store, you know, otherwise personal information that would be hidden from people's eyes. So let's just give this random number a search and see what it comes up with. Okay, firstly, let's point out that this search result has returned 71.6 million results for this number up here. And as you can see, there are phone numbers that are coming up. Okay, it's not the one we're searching for. If it was, it would be totally in bold, but it's at least got some of the numbers in there. Let's scroll down and see if the total number comes up on the page. And usually if it does, it's going to be, you know, right at the top here. As you can see, the closest match in this instance is this particular number, but it's not really what we're looking for. So here's a technique you can use. It's an advanced searching technique with Google. It's placing double quotation marks around some or all of your search criteria. And let's just hit that again, because it's going to narrow the results down. As you can see, it's turned from 71 million down into 87. So, okay, now we've got this particular number here, but it doesn't have the area code. Let's scroll down. Okay, nope, doesn't look like it's there. Okay, as I said, you know, this is a method that, well, it's not completely guaranteed, but you'd be surprised just, you know, how lucky you might get with this. Another way is, you know, actually going to places like MySpace and logging in and doing a search. You'll find that people have stored a lot of information on there, and you never know, you just might find what you're looking for. Another site that we can go to is called boardtracker.com, and that is a site where you'll be able to search through different discussion boards where people, you know, leave their personal information for being contacted, whether or not they're, you know, looking for a job or looking to sell something, or just to discuss some information. It's a good way to find something out as well. Okay, so why don't we just head across now and check out the reversephonedirectory.net and see if we can find that there, because we haven't done too well with our free methods right up to now, and this is something that you know, you might get lucky with, you might not. So let's head across to reverse-phone-directory.net, or you can simply click the link that should be beside this video somewhere on the page, and we'll give that a shot there and see if we can find whether or not that's even a real number. Okay, so here we are. Let's just enter that number again. Now, if I remember correctly, it was 614 529-6263. Let's enter the number and hit the search now button and see what comes up. I guess we're not guaranteed to find if, you know, if this is not actually a real number, but we'll find out in just a minute. Okay, there you go. Look, it is actually a real number. It's returned a successful result for 614-529-6263. And this phone number happens to be located in Ohio, Hilliard, Ohio. It's a landline. And, you know, by the look of this map here, we get a pretty good idea where this person is located. Right about there. Okay, if we scroll down a little, we get to see a bit more information. Oh, this is all totally for free at this point. We've got the number listed, the date we've searched, the area. Okay, a bit of information is being displayed for free. You know, should we want to go ahead and get the full report and find out exactly who belongs to that cell phone number that has been calling my cell, or maybe it's been my spouse's cell? You know, we just go ahead and click the report now. So why don't we just do that and see what it comes up with? Okay, we get a return result here of well, looks like two options. We can go for the premium membership at $39.95, or, you know, selecting the single tracer report. I guess it's completely up to you. You know, if you're going to be doing this a fair bit and, you know, you want to get access to some of the free, well, included advanced reports where you can do background checks and criminal records, then, you know, going for the $39.95 option is, you know, going to be best value for you. But if in this case, you know, perhaps you're just wanting to do a, you know, single cell phone lookup and you're looking for a one-time report, at $40.95, you know, it represents, I guess, fairly good value. One thing to point out here is that, you know, you can make your own cell phone information private by selecting this box. You'll get an opportunity once you've purchased to remove your own information from the database. And you know, it's something worth considering if you don't want anybody to go ahead and do this kind of reverse cell phone lookup on you. But it's entirely up to you. So if we just hit the checkout button, you know, we're happy with what we've selected here. Let's see what it comes up with. What does it actually cost us? Okay, we're going to select our payment. As you can see, at $90.90, you know, we're on the checkout page, and you can either pay with PayPal or you can use a credit card. It's entirely up to you. Well, look, I hope this has been a helpful exercise, and certainly you may not even need to use this or get this far. You can try the free methods that I've shown you, and who knows, you might just come up with what you're looking for. But if not, the reversephonedirectory.net has got a guaranteed way that if somebody's cell phone is in there, you can get access to the report for, you know, a fairly cheap fee. So I hope you found this helpful, and good luck with your searching, and have a great day.